you had 2 keys, a 10 roof. Turn up, we on Tiller, we just getting loose. Baby, I'm low-key feeling you. Don't be cynical and fuck you over. Wanna fuck you over, and again, the truth is I ain't.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So today's video, I just wanted to talk about the Navy. The Navy is a part of my everyday life. I normally don't talk about work and stuff like that and everything that I do on a daily basis other than like fashion and stuff that, you know, because I have a life outside of the Navy and I try to keep my personal life and my Navy life separate. So I just wanted to give you guys a little backstory on me. My name's Akiva. I've been in the Navy for a little over 8 years. I'll be at my 9-year mark on August 11th. I came back in the Navy and back here in 2011. I joined right out of high school. I was 17. My mama had to sign a paper for me to go ahead and go to MEPS and stuff like that because I kind of knew like the Navy is what I wanted to do. I had one point wanted to go to college. I wanted to go to North Carolina A&T, but my mom was like, you need to go to the Navy because the Navy's gonna pay for your school and you're gonna have all those student loans. And she was right. Like, I don't have student loans now. The Navy pays for my school, so I'm in a good predicament. I'm better than if I had went to college or not. I still don't have my degree, which is kind of hard though, because being on sea duty, it's kind of hard to go to school because you're in and out to sea all the time. It's hard to have, sometimes they cut off all communication sometimes out to sea. You go into River City and stuff like that, so you can't always like have that communication on land, so it makes it difficult to go to school. That's why they teach classes on the ship, and I definitely took advantage of those times where I could take classes. Now, I did go to school while I'm on shore duty. I'm currently on shore duty. I'm finishing up my pregnancy tour. Well, actually, I was PCS to shore duty on normal orders. I ended up getting pregnant in January of last year, had the baby, and they extended me for a year. So now I go back out to sea October of this year. And when I mean go out to sea, I don't mean technically go out to sea. Yes, I probably will go out to sea, but I'm talking about being on a seagoing command, like that may deploy and stuff like that. Right now I'm stationary and I don't have to go nowhere, which is good. Okay, back to what I was saying. Kind of got off topic a little bit, but okay. I am a BM1. I'm an E6 petty officer. This is an E6 first class petty officer. I made E6 recently, like a year ago. It took me 7.5 years to advance to BM1. A BM1 is a bosun mate, and first class is my rank, obviously. But a bosun mate, we do a lot of stuff. Like, it's not easy, I'm gonna tell you that. As a lower ranking BM, like a seaman, coming in a seaman, you have to build your way up. You be painting, sanding, doing grunt work. You'll be nothing. Honestly, you'll be a body, which that's what the Navy is. You're just a body and you're gonna get replaced and replaced and replaced. But anyway, if you stick to it and you work yourself up through the ranks, then you become more supervisional to personnel once you get more rank. So as a BM3, you still get the pain and all that stuff, and not really. But as you get to BM2 and BM1, you run in a deck place. You're a leader. You're being a leader at BM2, but BM1, you're the leader. You're the lead petty officer of your division. I haven't experienced being a LPO at sea yet, so that's why I'm in the process right now of picking orders to go to a ship so I can lead and I can make a chief. So hopefully I can make chief by the time I leave my next command. I'm trying to shoot for, you know, the 12-year mark, but we'll see how it goes and what the next command is looking like. Hopefully I'll meet all my goals or whatever. But for you new people who are coming into the military, I can say things are always changing. it's the good, it's the bad, which is any job. At one point I wanted to get out, but then it's like, this is, excuse my language, this shit is too easy, like, to get out. Like, it's easy. The hardest part is being away from your family, honestly. I just had a baby, and I'm just preparing myself, my mind, to leave my child for a couple months to go out to sea or do a deployment. Even though I don't want to, I'm gonna be sick, I'm gonna be so depressed. But, I mean, I gotta do it. It's people out here doing it, single parents out here doing it, so that's that. So, for you guys that are coming in, because I know, like, I had a lot of questions when I was coming into the military. Honestly, you guys can drop comments in the comment section below and let me know what questions you have about the military, because I've been in so long, like, I can tell you some things, okay? If you really want me to go into it, if you have PT questions, physical training, boot camp. Now, boot camp may have changed because I went in 2011 and 2020, so we'll see. If I don't know the answer, I can find it for you. I can look up instructions and whatnot. Just let me know. Drop the comment section below, and I'll see you. So, I made a list. This is my list. Don't gotta be nobody else's list or whatever. This is my opinion. You don't have to agree. That's fine, but it's my list. So I made a list to talk about the pros and the cons of being in the Navy. Granted, because I have been in so long, so I've seen all sides, because I've been on shore duty and I've been on a ship. I've been in the shipyards, so I can tell you some things. Okay, so the pros. Traveling, okay. I have traveled so much on the Navy's dime, okay. I'm gonna name some countries I've been to. I've been to Greece, Spain, Dubai, Bahrain, Singapore. I've been to Hawaii. Where else have I been? There's so many, y'all. England, Portugal. And I feel like I'm missing something, but just to name those is amazing. And I didn't have to pay anything because I went with the Navy. So travel, you travel for free. If you're on an aircraft carrier, I will tell you, which I was on an aircraft carrier, so I haven't hit as many ports as you, somebody who would be on a small ship, has hit. Because the small ships, they can go in and out everywhere. We, the carriers, we only can hit certain ports because we're so big. So while we're out to sea on the carrier, y'all hitting all these little ports. We be out to sea, this how I went. 30 days out to sea, hit a port. 30 days out to sea, hit a port. We, the longest I've been out to sea with no land is 60 days. And when I tell you that was hard, like, oh my God, it was so depressing. It's like they teased us, like they pulled us in, and then it was like, oh, we can't pull in. Like, we had our mooring lines laid out on deck and everything, and like ready, like at seeing anchor. Seeing anchor is when you're about, they said seeing anchor when you're about pulling, but we was at seeing anchor and couldn't even pull in, and we went right back out to sea. Talking about mad. I'm so mad. Okay. So traveling, free school, I already mentioned that. It's so many ways that you can pay for your schooling. CLEP is one. CLEP is basically you go sign up and you get study material and you test out of whatever, say English. You study the English and they give you little study guides, and if you think you can pass it, go test out. You can fail it one time for free, and if you want to take it again, I think it's like $150 or something like that, and then you can retake it. But I mean, hell, if you can pass it and it's free the first time, like, why not? So you can get your credits that way, because the Navy has really made it hard for people to get their education, because you can only get like 4 credits a year. Like it's gonna take forever to get a degree. Like, so you gotta use your other options. There's also this thing called NC Pace. Now, I used NC Pace when I was on the ship. NC Pace is basically like you take a book, you get a book, they'll give you a book or whatever. I did child growth and development, so I had a book. And you pace yourself. You can do it on your own time. It just goes by, like, on the weeks that you should be. Like, week one, do this, complete this assignment. And then you go to your ship's personnel office. And, like, I would go take the test and quiz. He'll put it in for me. Then I do the final. I did all this stuff on the ship. So, that was an easy little credit for me. Okay, so when you get out, you're... you bring your in, like the post 9/11 or the GI Bill, you have that, and you can transfer those to your children, but you have to do a certain amount of time. I don't know the time right off the top of my head, but if you have those questions, I can get the answers for you. And right now, I'm currently using tuition assistance. Basically, I just picked the college that I wanted to go to, picked the classes, routed the paperwork up through my chain of command. They approved it and basically took it to my education service officer. And they approved the and gave me a voucher, and it paid for my school. So I started school on 24th again. It's such an easy process to go to school. If you're in the Navy and I'm going to school, like, baby, what are you doing? Okay? Another pro is meeting people. I have met people from all walks of life, all over the country, different ethnicities everywhere. It's like the Navy is such a big melting pot. Like, I like it. I love meeting new people. And you meet lifelong friends, honestly. So, I would say that's a pro. Okay, quals. Now, you can get quals that you can use on the outside world. Like, say you want, like, for both of me, you have rigor. I have a rigging NEC, which is a rigor weight tester. So I can use that on the outside world. Like, I can go to somebody's shipyard and I can be a rigger or a weight tester or whatever. Both of me are good with supplies because we transfer a lot of supplies when we're out to sea. So just different qualifications can lead you to working on the outside world. So don't let nobody tell you some stuff can't transfer outside in civilian work, because some stuff can. Now, these pins right here, I actually have three, but I'm only allowed to wear two on my uniform. This is my surface warfare pin. This is a requirement in the Navy now. It didn't used to be. But when you get on your first ship or your first command, whatever, if it's surface or air, you will get, you're required to get your pin. Now, after that, all the other pins are up to you. This is my third pin. I just decided I wanted to wear this one because I worked so hard for this pin. This is my IDW. This is the last one that I got, which is the information dominance pin. And I also have my air pin. It's so many pins in the Navy that you can earn. I plan on earning my expeditionary if I can get to a command that offers it. But these don't really do nothing for you on the outside world. They make you look good in the Navy if you try and make chief officer, whatever. It's like, it's good for you. It's a good look to see somebody walk around dual or triple qual. So if you can get in a command that's offering more than one pin, do that. If you're on an aircraft carrier, you can get your surface, air, and IDW. And that's how I got my three pins, all from being on an aircraft carrier. But if you're on a small ship, you're probably just not having your surface. Okay, where was I? Okay, another pro is there's this program. It's called the SkillBridge program. It's basically where you kind of go work for a company at the 6 months at the end of your contract to help you transition to the civilian sector. So I think that's an excellent program. People learn about that in TAPS class. So if you're in the Navy and you're transitioning out, you learn about SkillBridge in TAPS class. Okay, another one is living on your own. I feel like the Navy made me very independent at an early age. I was living on my own, had my own car, like, you know, stuff I wasn't used to having at 17, 18, because I was living with my mom before I left for the Navy. So I feel like the Navy gives you a certain amount of independence because you're going to have some money when you get out of boot camp. I mean, it's just up to you to use it wisely. And when you go on deployment, that's the most money you're going to be having in your life. Okay, my first deployment, what did I say? My first deployment, I was a seaman. I think I saved like $10,000, $15,000. And I give myself a little spending limit in every port, and I was just stacking up. So I just can't wait till my next appointment because I know I'm gonna be saving some money. Okay. Last one, y'all, for pros. Okay, healthcare and dental. I'm not gonna say it's the best, but it is free. So, you know, free isn't always that great. But, I mean, hey. But you get free prescriptions if you go out in town and they prescribe you a prescription at, say, Rite Aid or Walgreens. Your prescription is free because you're in the Navy. So, it has its parts, but... we ain't gonna talk about medical and dental, but it's a pro because it's free. You don't have to pay for it, but not always the best. But I'll say that's a pro. Cons. Okay. I don't have too many issues with the Navy, so my cons lists are really short. So I'm just gonna say for my cons, deployment and ship schedule. Sometimes it can be unpredicting. Deployments are rough. You're away from your family, your husbands, your wives, your kids, and y'all in the middle of the ocean. People gonna start to get on your nerves because you see these people every day and you just get tired of it. It's just a routine. You wake up, you do the same thing every day. So it can get a little rough. So. I mean, but in the Navy, you gotta deploy, so it just comes with the territory. But it is, I would say, it is very hard to be away from your family and being on deployments and stuff like that. But it's also fun when you look back on it. You'd be like, oh, I visited all these places. I saved all this money. I got these quals. Because when you leave for deployment, you should come back a better you. Like, you should set your goals. Like, this is what I'm going to accomplish these 9 months out here. And I'm just going to come back a better person. Like, I came back triple qualed on my last deployment. Stacked up with some money. I had a Navy Achievement Medal. I accomplished so many things. Like, I can't even say how proud I was. And I also got injured and flew off the ship and came back and still did all these things because I'm a go-getter. And it just is what it is. Okay, I already said underways and workups. Underways and workups is basically you're working up before your deployment. That means you're just going out to sea, coming back, and it's just like you could be doing that for a whole year. And it's just stressful because it's like, dang, I gotta go underway today for like 2 weeks, and you out to sea for 2 weeks. Like, but yeah, I would say that's a con. Shipyards. Okay, so my first ship was the USS Theodore Roosevelt, and when I got on there, we were in the shipyards. A shipyard is not really a place to go for a new sailor. Like, this thinking they about to be a super sailor, be out on the water and all this stuff. The shipyards will tear you down and you will be losing all hope. Like, it's called a career killer. But I would say that's a con. Some people like it because you don't have to leave your family and stuff like that. But as a new sailor with no family and stuff, you're trying to learn the Navy, especially if you want to stay in. So I would say, you know, that is that's a con for me. I don't like the shipyard environment. It's industrial. You have hard hats, safety glasses on at all times. It's just not fun to be in the shipyards. You'd rather be operational. Hey, I already expressed being away from your family. Another con for new sailors is you don't really have a say on where you go on your first tour. Like, you don't really get to pick. But after that, like, after you complete your first tour, you have a thing called My Navy Assignment now, and you can go in and you can make like a little wish list, and then, you know, your detailer, you can negotiate. You can talk to your detailer at that point, but it's not talking to your detailer when you first get issued orders for your first command. So it's what it kind of what you get needs in the Navy, whatever. And another con is choose your rate, choose your fate. I ain't gonna say that's a con, but people choose rates in the Navy at first, and they don't really know what it is or what it's like, and then they end up hating it. Like, So I chose being a bosomate, but I thought I was going to hate it so bad, but I kind of like this shit. Like, it's really, it's hardcore. It gives you an adrenaline rush, but you also got people's lives in your hands. It's safety is involved, like, because you're doing a lot of things that can go wrong and it's unsafe, could be unsafe. But I would say that, you know, when you're choosing your rate in the Navy, please be mindful of what you like to do. If you like working on things, because you don't want, honestly, I'm getting tongue-tied, sorry y'all, but you don't want to be in a rate for 4 years, 4 or 5 years, and you don't like it. Because then you're going to just hate the Navy, have resentment. But I will say, regardless of what you get, do what you're supposed to do, be on time, have a good uniform, grooming standards, and you're going to be all right and get your quals and don't go dink and keep your name out of the spotlight, then you won't have no issues being in the Navy, because that's all it is, honestly. Okay, and last but not least, I forgot this pro, and it's my last statement. Retirement. Retirement at 20 years is great. I am so happy I'm about to be in my 10-year mark next year, because that means I'm halfway through this journey. I'm not doing a day over 20, okay? Unless for some reason I'm going to be an officer by then, but whoo, child, this is a lot of work. It's fun, but at the same time, I'm just ready to, I can't wait to be done, because I don't want to leave my child no more. So, but that concludes my video. I just wanted to talk to you guys about the Navy, my pros and my cons list, and just give you a little insight about me and my everyday, like, life. This is what I do every day, go to work. Yeah, so please, if you have any comments or questions regarding the bosomate rate, standards, PRT, grooming, anything. I mean, anything. You can ask me and drop the comments below. So, thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys have a great Navy day. Bye.
This is what happened when I think about you.